as we gather together to celebrate these Easter mysteries, let us gather together this gospel. We'll ask this morning for Winifred Almeida, whose anniversary occurs at this time. Our prayers are with her family and for her miracles of her soul. Lord Jesus, you are Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you lead us to the Father. Christ, have
mercy. Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you plead for us at the right hand of God. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. May your right hand, O Lord, we pray, encompass your family with perpetual help, so that defended from all wickedness by the resurrection of your only begotten Son, we may make our way by means of your heavenly gifts. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. With the connivance of the authorities, a move was made by the pagans as well as Jews to make attacks on Paul and Barnabas and to stone them. When the apostles came to hear of this, they went off for safety to Lycia, there in the towns of Lycia and Derbe, and in the surrounding country. They preached the good news. A man sat there who had never walked in his life because his feet were crippled from birth. And as he listened to Paul preaching, he managed to catch his eye. Seeing that the man had the faith to be cured, Paul said in a loud voice, "Get to your feet, stand up." And the cripple jumped up and began to walk. When the crowd saw what Paul had done, they shouted in the language of Lycaonia, "These people are gods who have come down to us, disguised as men." They addressed Barnabas as Zeus, and since Paul was the principal speaker, they called him Hermes. The priests of Zeus outside the gate, proposing that all the people should offer sacrifice to them, brought garland oxen to the gates. When the apostles, Barnabas and Paul, heard what had happened, they tore their clothes and rushed into the crowd, shouting, "Friends, what do you think you are doing? We are only human beings like you. We have come with good news to make you turn from these empty idols to the living God, who made heaven and earth and the sea and all that these hold. In the past, he allowed each nation to go its own way. But even then, he did not leave you without evidence of himself. In the good things he does for you, he sends you rain from heaven to make your crops grow. When they should, he gives you food and makes you happy." Even this speech, however, was scarcely enough to stop the crowd from offering them sacrifice. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Not to us, Lord, but to your name give the glory.
Not to us, Lord, but to your name give the glory.
Not to us, Lord, not to us, but to your name give the glory. For the sake of your love and your truth, or lest the heathen say, "Where is their God?" Not to us, Lord, but to your name give the glory. Our God, he is in the heavens. He does whatever he wants. Their idols are silver and gold, the work of human hands. Not to us, Lord, but to your name, O Lord. May you be blessed by the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. The heavens belong to the Lord, but the earth he has given to men. Not to us, Lord, but to your name, O Lord. Hallelujah. Alleluia. Christ has risen and shone upon us, whom he redeemed with his blood. Alleluia.
So let us turn in prayer for the Lord, to the Lord this day. Pray for the church throughout our life. It may always be a means in which people find God's love and God's peace. Lord, in your mercy, we pray for peace amongst the nations. We pray especially for those who are striving to bring peace in the Holy Land, in Sudan and in Ukraine. That they will always trust that their neighbours will have benefits. Lord, in your mercy, pray for ourselves and our journeys of faith, that we may show to others the goodness of the Lord. Lord, in your mercy, pray for those who are sick in mind or in body, and pray that they may find healing and peace. Lord, in your mercy, for those who have died recently and those whose anniversaries occurred this time, for families who grieve in mourn, that they may have the hope of the resurrection and the life. Lord, in your mercy, and we ask for the prayers of Mary, Queen of Heaven, to be praised again. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen. We make the use of all our prayers through Jesus Christ, who is Lord forever and ever. Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have this bread to offer. which earth is given and human hands have made, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May our prayers rise up to you, O Lord, together with the sacrificial offerings, so that purified by your graciousness, we may be conformed into the mysteries of your mighty love. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to lord you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our answer from death, and in his rising the life of all is risen. Therefore overcome with passing joy, every land and every people exalts in your presence, and even the heavenly powers, with the angelic hosts, sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they enter. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who passes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy then these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed, and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you will drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Declan, our Bishop, and all who serve your name. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, Winifred our leader for whom we offer this Mass, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, through the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, Saint John the Baptist, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. Save this man, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Saviour, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign for ever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lord. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Almighty ever living God, who restores us to eternal life in the resurrection of Christ, increase in us, we pray, the fruits of this passing sacrament, and pour into our hearts the strength of this same food, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go forth, the Mass.